Hi, this is Michelle Barnacle again. Right now we're going to talk about subtracting whole numbers. And when we are subtracting whole numbers, the main thing you're going to see is word problems in today's math books. So an example of a word problem would be that Keisha has $713. She wants to buy an iPhone and it cost $199. So we want to know how much left she is going to have in her account. So in order to do that, what do? We're going to subtract, because you're taking away what it costs for the iPhone, and we're going to see how much she has left. So in order to do this, we need to know a little bit about the vocabulary. The $713 that you start with is called the menu end. The $199 that we're going to take away is called the subtrahend, because that's what you're subtracting. The $514 would be the difference. So that's what you have left over. So the word difference is the answer to a subtraction problem. There are other words underneath that that also mean subtraction. And now we're going to work a couple of examples of basic subtraction problems, and then I'm going to show you how to check them using addition to make sure that you did it correctly. So we're going to go to the board now. And the first problem that we're going to do is 371, and we're going to take away 40. So what we want to do when you do subtraction, you always want to start from the right to the left, and you start in the ones column. 1 take away 0 gives me 1. 7, I'm taking away 4, and that leaves me 3. I have 3 in the hundreds place. I'm not taking anything away, so I still have 300. So the answer that I believe is correct is 331. So the way we check our answer is to do addition to see if we get back what we started with. So when I do that, I have 331, and I want to add back the 40 that I took away. And when I do that again, I start all the way to the right, which is the ones column, and that gives me 1. In the tens column, 3 plus 4 makes 7. And in the hundreds column, I just bring the 3 down. Because I got what I started with, I know that I did it correctly. Now let's do one that's a little more challenging, because it requires us to borrow or regroup, as they call it now. You cannot take 7 away from 4, so what do we have to do? We have to go and borrow. So when I go next door and I borrow, I'm borrowing a group of 10. That group of 10 that I borrow make this 4 into a 14. And over here, when I borrowed a group of 10, he was 10 to start with, but now he became 9. When I borrowed from him, I had to also borrow from the guy next door to him. He was 11, and when I had to borrow, he went down to 10. I also had to borrow from the next man, and he was a 10. He now becomes a 9. And the last guy I had to borrow was a 5, and he becomes a 4. Anytime you have to do borrowing, if the bigger number is on the bottom and the smaller number is on the top, you have to borrow so that you can do the subtraction, because you cannot take a bigger number from a smaller number. So you have 14, and we're going to take away 7, and that leaves us 7. We're taking 9, take away 8, and that leaves me 1. We have 10, and we're taking away 6, that leaves me 4. I have 9, I'm taking away all 9, that leaves me 0. I have 4, and I'm taking away 1, and that leaves me 3. So this is the answer, 30,417, that I believe is correct. So in order to see if I did it correctly, I want to add back what I took away to see if I get 50,104. So in order to do that, I'm going to save room. And I'm going to add 19,687 right underneath my answer to see if I got this correct. So when I do this, I have 7 plus 7 makes 14. Write down my 4 and carry my 1. I'm writing that in green so you can see. 8 plus 1 makes 9, plus one more that I carried over makes 10. So I carry that 1, put the 0 down. 6 plus 4 makes 10. Plus the one that I carried That makes 11. 9 plus 0 is 9, plus the one that I carried makes 10. Carry that one. And then 1 plus 3 is 4, plus that one is 5. And yes, I did get what I started with, so I know that I did that correctly. And that is all I have to say for subtraction of whole numbers, and we're going to do another lesson shortly. Thank you.